What's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to show you how you can make these adapters so that you can switch from your shop vac to 2-inch PVC pipe. I use a lot of shop vacs for dust collection, so being able to switch into the PVC has been a huge help here in my shop, although I could see a lot of other benefits besides just dust collection for being able to use 2-inch PVC with your shop vac. Now, in order to make these adapters, first we're going to have to make a jig, so I'm going to show you how to make that jig, but after you have the jig, these things cost about 10 cents and they only take about 15 seconds to make on the table saw. So, lots of good reasons to do it. Let's get right into it. You're gonna wanna start off with a block. I'm gonna be using a 2x10, but you could probably use any kind of 2x material. You could even double up a couple pieces of 3/4 plywood. One edge needs to be perfectly straight, so to get this, I'm gonna screw a short piece of plywood on and run it through the table saw. Now that I have that straight edge, right in the center of the straight cut, trace a circle using a short piece of 2-inch pipe. And the pipe needs to be flush, the outside of the pipe, with the back side of that straight cut. Now you're gonna wanna cut a hole, a perfect circle. This could be done with many different types of saws. I'm going to be using a jigsaw here just because I figured most people would have a jigsaw. And to show that it could be done with a jigsaw, as long as you take your time and just sneak up on that circle. Once you end up with a nice tight fit like this, you've got it. Now it's going to be so tight that it's not going to spin, and you need to be able to spin the pipe. So here I'm just gonna sand it a little bit until eventually I'm able to spin the pipe within this circle. Now you can open up the sides of the circle, cut a couple of short clamping blocks, pre-drill some holes into these blocks, and attach one to either side of the back of the jig. Make sure that the screws that you use are long enough so you get a good secure attachment to the bottom board. And that's it. The jig is complete. Now it's time to cut these down, these blanks, to 2.5 inches. And they need to be really square, so I'm gonna use the miter saw. You could probably use a different saw, but I think the miter saw is probably the easiest and most accurate way to cut these. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut a bunch of these up and we'll go from there. Now I'm over here at the table saw, and what I want to do is reference the center of the blade up here on my fence, or even on the top of the fence, either way. It doesn't have to be exact, but it's got to be pretty close. And then what I want to do is get the blade up to 1.25 inches. The inside diameter of the vacuum fitting is about 2.25. The outside diameter of the 2-inch PVC pipe is 2 3/8. So we're going to need to reduce the pipe by 1/8 of an inch, and we're going to do that by removing 1/16 all the way around. So we need to set the fence on the table saw at 2 5/16. Depending on what kind of table saw you're working on, this is going to be different. But basically, I know the blade is up 1.25 inches. So what I'm going to do is count how many revolutions it's going to take to spin the blade back down. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It takes 10 revolutions to get my blade down 1.25 inches. So it's going to take 10 revolutions to get my blade up to my finished height. So what I'm going to do is set my jig over the center mark, and I'm going to clamp it on. And now that I have it clamped on, I can turn my saw on and run it up 10 revolutions. Okay, here I'm just going to show you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So here's the blade all the way up to 1.25 inches. So I'm going to run that back down. We're ready to start. It's going to be a tight fit, and that's what you want. It's going to spin in there, and each time you want to raise the blade one revolution. You also want to make sure that you're applying pressure to the pipe each time that you raise the blade. And it's a little too tight. I'm gonna run the blade back down. I'm gonna pull the fence over just a little bit and give that a go. Once you get them pretty close, you're gonna hit them a little bit with some sandpaper. Mostly just to knock the fuzz off and smooth them up a little bit. But after you have a nice tight fit like you want, got the jig dialed in, you can go into production. Make as many of them as you want. My hand is starting to cramp up. Usually people are only going to need like one or two, so doing this by hand is probably fine. But if this works, this should definitely enhance the production a little bit. Just give me one sec. That worked perfect. Perfect. Look at that thing. Just look at that. Look how beautiful that is. Oh my goodness. Look at that. I just put the P in production.